بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful.
نستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا ومطاعنا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: أم حسبتم أن تدخلوا الجنة ولما يأتكم مثل الذين خلوا من قبلكم مستهم البأساء والضراء وزلزلوا حتى يقول الرسول والذين آمنوا معه متى نصر الله؟ ألا إن نصر الله قريب. صدق الله العظيم. عن أبي ذر جندب بن جلال رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يرويه عن ربه تبارك وتعالى أنه قال: وجعلته بينكم محرما فلا تظالموا، يا عبادي كلكم ضال إلا من هديته فاستهدوني أهدكم، يا عبادي كلكم جائع إلا من أطعمته فاستطعموني أطعمكم، يا عبادي كلكم عار إلا من كسوته فاستكسوني أكسكم، إلى آخر الحديث، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Respected علماء الكرام, elders and beloved brothers in Islam, Iman demands and declaration of the kalima la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم necessitates the absolute conviction in our hearts that each and everything in this entire universe, each and everything that exists, whether we can see it, whether we cannot see it, whether we can perceive it, whether we cannot perceive it, whether it is within the realms of the human understanding or whether it is beyond our understanding, everything that exists is the creation of one Allah. Allahu khaliqu kulli shay. Allah has created everything. To this extent that Mufassirin explain that Allah says, Allahu khaliqu kulli shay, Allah has created every shay. What is shay? They say, ma siwa Allah. Everything besides Allah is the creation of Allah. Lahu ma fi samawati wa ma fi al-ardi wa ma baynahuma wa ma tahta al-thara. To Allah belongs everything in the heavens, everything in the earth, everything between the heavens and the earth, and everything beneath the earth. ألا إن لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض ألا إن لله من في السماوات ومن في الأرض. Every cell in our bodies, every atom in this universe is totally and completely the milkiyat, the possession of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah alone has brought it into existence. Allah alone is keeping it in existence. And when its existence terminates also, it will not terminate of its own accord, but it will terminate on the will, on the irada, on the intention of one Allah. Whatever happens, happens on His intention. يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah does as He wills. يَخْلُقُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah creates whatever He wills. يَهْدِي مَن يَشَاءُ. Allah guides whom He wills. يُضِلُّ مَن يَشَاءُ. Allah deviates whom He wills. تُعِزُّ مَن تَشَاءُ. Izzat, respect, Allah gives to whom He wills. تُذِلُّ مَن تَشَاءُ. Zillat and disgrace and bringing one down, Allah does to whom He wills. يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. Allah gives wealth to whom He wills. Allah withholds wealth from whom He wills. أَضْحَكَ وَأَبْكَى. Happiness to whom Allah wills. Sadness to whom Allah wills. أَمَاتَ وَأَحْيَى. Life to whom Allah wills. Death to whom Allah wills. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Whatever happens, happens on the mashiyat, on the will, on the irada of one Allah. مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ كَانْ كَمَا شَاءَ كَانْ فِي الْوَقْتِ الَّذِي شَاءَ عَلَى الْوَجْهِ الَّذِي شَاءَ مِنْ غَيْرِ زِيَادَةٍ وَلَا نُقْصَانٍ وَلَا تَقَدُّمٍ وَلَا تَأَخُّرٍ وَمَا لَمْ يَشَأْ لَمْ يَكُنْ. Whatever happens, that which Allah wills will happen. It will happen in the time that Allah wants it to happen. It will happen in the manner in which Allah wants it to happen. It will not happen before Allah wanted. It will not happen after Allah wants. It will not happen more than that which Allah wants. It will not happen less than that which Allah wants. وَمَا لَمْ يَشَأْ لَمْ يَكُنْ. And that which Allah does not will, all the forces of this earth can get together. They will not ever bring it into existence. هُوَ الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ إِلَهُ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَهُ. Allah is the ilah of the heavens. Allah is the ilah of the earth. Allah is the giver of life. Allah is the giver of death. Allah is the giver of health. Allah is the giver of sickness. In fact, when Allah begins His Quran, when Allah begins His kitab, أَلِفْ لَامْ مِيمْ ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. This is the book. In it there is absolutely no doubt. هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. It is hidayat. It is guidance for those with taqwa. And Allah speaks of the basic, most fundamental level of hidayat. الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. That whether it is beneath the earth, whether it is the minerals, whether it is the platinum, whether it is the iron ore, whether it is the gold, whether it is the silver, whether it is the multitudes of elements, multitudes of minerals that Allah has kept concealed beneath the earth, whether it is the surface of the earth, whether it is the mountains, whether it is the rivers, whether it is the trees, whether it is the birds, whether it is the insects, whether it is humankind, whether it is jinnat, whether it is the animals, whether it is the lions, whether it is the cheetahs, whether it is the elephants, whether it is the seas, whether it is the multitudes of creations living within the seas, whether it is the whales, whether it is the sharks, whether it is moving upwards the sky, whether it is the clouds, whether it is the asteroids, whether it is the comets, whether it is the planets, whether it is the sun, whether it is the stars moving upwards, the first heaven, the angels of the first heaven, second heaven, the angels of the second heaven, third heaven, fourth heaven, fifth heaven, sixth heaven, seventh heaven, and all the angels, whether it is the sea above that, whether it is the kursi of Allah, whether it is the arsh of Allah, whether it is the hamilini arsh, the angels holding aloft the arsh of Allah, وَيَحْمِلُ عَرْشَ رَبِّكَ فَوْقَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ ثَمَانِيَا. Eight angels are holding aloft the arsh of Allah, whether it is Jibra'il, whether it is Mikael, whether it is Israfil, whether it is Israel. The basic, most fundamental level of hidayat, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. That from the earth till the arsh of Allah, everything is dead. Nothing benefits, nothing harms, nothing gives life, nothing gives death, nothing gives respect, nothing gives disgrace, nothing gives wealth, nothing gives poverty, nothing gives benefit, nothing gives harm. إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Except one Allah. Singularly, alone, controlling everything. هُوَ الَّذِي سَخَّرَ الْبَحَرِ. The seas belong to Allah. سَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْأَنْهَارِ. The rivers belong to Allah. وَالْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ دَحَاهَا. The earth belongs to Allah. أَخْرَجَ مِنْهَا مَاءَهَا وَمَرْعَاهَا. The waters belong to Allah. The crops and the grains belong to Allah. تَصْرِيفِ الرِّيَاحِ. The winds belong to Allah. وَالسَّحَابِ الْمُسَخَّرِ. The clouds belong to Allah. يُغْشِ اللَّيْلَ النَّهَارِ. Day and night belongs to Allah. يُولِجُ اللَّيْلَ فِي النَّهَارِ. Lengthening of the night belongs to Allah. يُولِجُ النَّهَارَ فِي اللَّيْلِ. Lengthening of the day belongs to Allah. Everything alone. Allah, هو الأول ليس قبله شيء. He was the first, before Him there is nothing. الآخر ليس بعده شيء. He was the last, after Him there is nothing. الأول بلا بداية. He was the first without a beginning. والآخر بلا نهاية. He is the last without an ending. Al-awwal bila makan. Allah is the first of the first, not confined to space. Aynama tuwallu fa thamma wajhullah. Turn in any direction and you will find Allah. Al-akhir bila zaman. Allah is the last, not confined to time. When Habib-e-Pak, Habib-e-Mustafa, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praises his Allah, then he turns to Allah, addresses him, supplicates to him in the following manner: Ya Malla Tarahul Uyun, O that Allah whom no eye sees, understand Allah's greatness, understand His fulqiyat, understand His height, understand His honor, understand His majesty. When it comes to height, La Tudrikuhul Absar, no eye sees Allah. Ar Rahman ala al arsh istawa. Rahman is upon His arsh. What is arsh? How high? Sahaba asked. Once Nabi Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed his companions, Hal tadarun, kam bayna samai wal ard. O my Sahaba, do you know the distance between the earth and the first heaven? Between the earth and the first heaven. Leave beyond that. Sahaba were not arrogant. They were not carried away by their own logic. They were not carried away by their puny intellect. They were not carried away by their so-called intelligence. With one voice, Allahu wa Rasuluhu A'lam. Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam know best. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells them, Bainahuma masiratu khamsi mi'ati sana. From the earth to the first heaven is a distance of 500 years. وَإِنَّ يَوْمًا عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ كَأَلْفِ سَنَةٍ مِمَّا تَعُدُّونَ. Not our years, not your years. One day by a Rabb is 1,000 years of this life. 500 such years that they say the sun, وَالشَّمْسُ تَجْرِي لِمُسْتَقَرٍ لَهَا ذَلِكَ التَّقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ وَالْقَمَرَ قَدَّرْنَاهُ مَنَازِلْ حَتَّى عَادَكَ الْعُرْجُونِ الْقَدِيمِ. The sun and the moon, creations of Allah, underneath the qudrat and the power of Allah. The sun alone, it is said, is 12,000 times the size of the earth. The diameter of this earth is 865,000 miles. The diameter of this earth is 24,000 miles. 24,000 miles. This earth is spinning itself and is spinning around the sun. Spinning at what speed? 1,000 miles per hour. 1,000 miles per hour this earth is spinning. 24,000 miles long. How long does it take to complete one circle at a speed of 1,000 miles per hour? 24 hours. And because of that, 12-hour day approximately, 12-hour night approximately. Which scientist set the speed? Which engineer came along and said to the earth and calculated on his fancy computer that you must spin at 1,000 miles per hour? If it was 500 miles per hour, then there would have been 24 hours day and 24 hours night. This poor insan would have worked and worked and worked till he got tired. And the day would never finish. Eventually when the day finishes after 24 hours, then it's 24 hours night. How long is he going to sleep? Allah knew the needs of His creation. It's a separate matter. Scientifically, they say if the day was 24 hours long, then the surface heat of the earth will increase to such an extent that every living thing will die. And if the night was 24 hours long, the surface temperature of the earth would drop to such an extent that whatever else was left because of cold would die. And if that speed, instead of being 500 miles, went away to 1,000 miles, went away to 2,000 miles, then instead of a 12-hour day, you got a 6-hour day. By the time you get through the traffic in Cape Town to your job, it's already night time. And then to get back, 6-hour night, by the time you get back home, it's the next day. Allah knew the needs of His creation. Which scientist set that speed? And carrying on. And this is just one, the earth. The sun is 12,000 times the size of this earth. We are carried away looking at the sun 93 million miles away from us, and we think that is something. The sun is only part of one galaxy. In that galaxy, there are millions of stars that are millions of times the size of the sun also. In one galaxy. Which is conjunction of 17 galaxies, what we call the Milky Way. It is said to move from one point to the other point of just this galaxy will take, at the speed of light, 186,282 miles per second. To move at that speed, it will take 2 million years to finish one galaxy. This galaxy in which we are in, and it is said that there are 500 million other galaxies. Right? We're not going into a science lesson. This is to make us understand the qudrat and the power of Allah. In front of all this, what is the haysiyat? What is the position of this insan in front of all this? That he feels, I am someone, I have intelligence, I have know-how. From their telescopes, they can only see 3 or 4% of the universe. What is somehow dunya below the first heaven, they can only see 3 or 4%. And in that 3 or 4%, they say there are so many stars, that if 1 second was given to name each star, it would take 300 trillion years. 300 trillion years just to name the stars. Just to name them. Forget the Allah that created them. Carried away over this small, tiny earth, this setup, this millionaire who's got a big bank balance feels that I am someone. What is his position in relation to what Allah has created? What is his position? Just the sun is 12,000 times the size of this earth. And this earth, it is said, if it is split up into 5 parts, this tiny, tiny earth in front of Allah's universe, if it is split up into 5 parts, 3 parts will be water. From the remaining 2 parts, 1 part will be forest and trees. And then 1 tiny part remains. And in that tiny part, 6 billion insan are living. Sharing the 1/5 of this tiny earth in front of Allah's creation in the city of Strand, which is now 1 tiny part of that 1/5, shared between so many millions and billions of insan, one person with a big bank balance sits in his office and says, I am somebody. What is his relation to everything around him? This is why in Urdu they say, agar apne haisiyat ko samajna, to apne office mein baith kar mat samjho, baitul khala mein baith kar samjho, ke mere andar se kya nikal rahe. That if you want to understand your position in relation to Allah's creation, don't sit in your office and judge. Sit in the toilet and judge that what is coming out of me. That still you have arrogance, still you have pride. That they say so and so said, and certain intelligentsia said, and certain intelligentsia said, understand, if they have shifted from Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then our little child of 5 or 6 years is more intelligent than them. It can be Einstein, it can be Newton, it can be the so-called intelligentsia. They spend their whole lives searching for answers. Who created the universe? Who created the universe? Who created the universe? And bicharas finish themselves in that. Today they have become the sand of the earth. Allah only knows what their position is in the qabr. A little 5-year-old child will ask, who created the universe? He will say, Allah. What is intelligence? Intelligence is that which emanated from Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ye sab bakte hai. They are all chanting and giving their own opinions. Sadaqallahu wa rasulu. Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam has spoken the truth. بَيْنَهُمَا مَسِيرَةُ خَمْسِمِيَةِ سَنَةٍ. From the earth to the first heaven is 500 years. وَمِنْ كُلِّ السَّمَاءٍ إِلَى السَّمَاءٍ مَسِيرَةُ خَمْسِمِيَةِ سَنَةٍ. And oh my sahaba, from the first to the second heaven, another 500 years. From the second to the third, another 500 years. Moving upwards to the seventh heaven. فَوْقَ السَّمَاءِ السَّابِعَةِ بَحْرٌ بَيْنَ أَسْفَلِهِ وَعَلَاهُ مَسِيرَةُ خَمْسِمِيَةِ سَنَةٍ. Above the seventh heaven is a sea. From the top to the bottom of that sea is another 500 years. ثُمَّ فَوْقَ ذَلِكَ ثَمَانِيَةُ أُعَالٍ. Then above that are 8 angels, what we term the Hamilin Arsh. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says they are in the shape of mountain goats, not like your ordinary sheep which you slaughter at the time of Qurbani. Bayna rukabihinna wa azlafihinna masiratu 500 sana. These sheep, these angels of Allah in the form of sheep are such that from their knees to their hooves is a distance of 500 years. Muslim Sharif riwayat, أذن لي أن أحدث عن ملك من ملائكة الله عز وجل من حملة العرش أنما بين شحمة أذنه إلى عاتقه مسيرة 700 سنة. Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that Allah gave me permission to tell you of just one angel that is holding his arsh. From the earlobe to the neck of a normal person is 5 or 6 centimeters. From the earlobe to the neck of that angel is a distance of 700 years. ثُمَّ عَلَىٰ ظُهُورِهِمُ الْعَرْشِ. And then on their backs is the arsh of Allah. بَعْدَمَا بَيْنَ قِطَرَيْهِ مَسِيرَةُ 50,000 سَنَةٍ. From one leg to the next leg is a distance of 50,000 years. And then is Allah, whose majesty and glory is such that all this is like not even one speck of dust in front of him. His fawqiyat is such, الرحمن على العرش استوى. Rahman is upon his arsh. ولكن فوقيته لا يزيده بعدا عن خلقه وهو أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد. But his فوقيت and his height and his majesty does not distance him from his slave. He is still closer to them than their jugular veins even. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. Allah says, we created you, we know when your heart is whispering to you, we are closer to you, closer to you. A pregnant woman carrying a child, that child is not as close to the mother as Allah is to each of his slaves. We are closer to you than your jugular veins. Sahaba Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam request the Nabi of Allah, أَقَرِيبٌ رَبُّنَا فَنُنَاجِي أَمْ بَعِيدٌ فَنُنَادِي. O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tell us, is our Allah far away? Is our Allah far away? Do we need to shout out to him? Or is he nearby? Can we whisper to him? Immediately the ayat of the Quran come down. وَإِذَا سَالَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my slaves are asking you about me. Tell them that I am very near. I am very near. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَان. I will answer them. I will answer them when they will call out to me. مَنْ دَلَّذِي سَالَنِي فَلَمْ أُعْطِهِ. Who is there that asked from Allah and was not granted? مَنْ دَلَّذِي قَرْ عَلَى بَابِي فَلَمْ أَفْتَحْلَى. Who is there that knocked at the door of Allah and that door was not open for them? Who is there that can make this claim? Allah is there. يَبْنَ آدَمْ إِنَّكَ مَا دَعَوْتَنِي وَرَجَوْتَنِي غَفَرْتُ لَكَ عَلَى مَا كَانَ مِنْكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. O insan, whenever you will call out to me, whenever you will have raja, whenever you will have hope, whenever you will turn to me, Allah says, I am there. I will answer your pleas. يَبْنَ آدَمْ لَوْ بَلَغَتْ ذُنُوبُكَ عَنَانَ السَّمَاءِ. O slave, O insan, O my banda, if you sin against me, and sin against me, and sin against me, till the whole earth, your sins fill up the whole earth, till it reaches right up till the heaven of Allah. ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَنِي. Then once with sincerity you turn to Allah and say, O Allah, forgive me. Oh my Allah, your slave has come back. Oh my Allah, Ajeeb. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once Jibreel alayhi salam tells him, that O Nabi of Allah, we write down the a'mal of your ummah. The malaika write down the a'mal of your ummah. But the malaika do not write down the tears of your ummah. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells Jibreel that, oh Jibreel, why are the tears of my ummah not written down? Jibreel alayhi salam tells him, inna dam'ata al-wahida min ummatik tutfi'u buhura an-nar. O Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one tear of your ummati will wipe out oceans of the fire of Jahannam. Will wipe out oceans of the fire of Jahannam. This is why the malaika do not even write down the tears of your ummah. ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَنِي. Once his sins may have filled the whole earth, reached right up to the heavens, once he will turn to Allah with sincerity, Allah says, غَفَرْتُ لَكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. I will wipe away all your sins and it will not matter to me. إِذَا تَابَ الْعَبْدُ يُعَلَّقُ لَهُ الْقَنَادِيلُ فِي السَّمَاءِ. When the slave of Allah comes back to Allah, lanterns are hung in the heavens. Lanterns are hung, and the angels in chorus with joy, اِصْطَلَحَ الْعَبْدُ عَلَى مَوْلَاهِ. اِصْطَلَحَ الْعَبْدُ عَلَى مَوْلَاهِ. The slave of Allah has come back to Allah. The slave of Allah has come back to Allah. Allah doesn't need us. Allah doesn't need us. Allah doesn't need the arrogance of this insan. Allah doesn't need the worship of this insan. Ya ibadi, lo anna awwalakum wa akhirakum wa insakum wa jinnakum wa hayyakum wa maytakum wa rabbakum wa yabisakum kanu ala atqa qalbi rajulin wahidin minkum ma zada dhalika fi mulki shay'a. O my slaves, if all of you have to come collectively unto my worship, each and every one of you has to worship me to the extent that all of you become like the most muttaqi. Your days are in ibadat, your nights are in ibadat, all of you become like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. مَا زَادَ ذَلِكَ فِي مُلْكِ شِيَا. The collective ibadat will not increase my greatness, not one bit. يَا عِبَادِي لَوْ أَنَّ أَوَّلَكُمْ وَآخِرَكُمْ وَإِنْسَكُمْ وَجِنَّكُمْ وَحَيَّكُمْ وَمَيِّتَكُمْ وَرَبَّكُمْ وَيَابِسَكُمْ كَانُوا عَلَىٰ أَفْجَرِ قَلْبِ رَجُلٍ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْكُمْ مَا نَقَصَ ذَلِكَ مِن مُلْكِ شِيَا. O my slaves, if all of you have to become fajir, have to become fasik, your days are in disobedience, your night are in disobedience, all of you become the slaves of shaitan, all of you become like shaitan, مَا نَقَصَ ذَلِكَ مِن مُلْكِ شِيَا. This will not diminish, this will not decrease from my greatness, not one bit. إنكم لن تبلغوا ضري فتضروني ولن تبلغوا نفعي فتنفعوني. You will never be able to benefit me. You will never be able to harm me. Allah is غني. Allah is independent. Allah is samad. Allah does not need His creation. يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء. Oh mankind, all of you are faqir, all of you are beggars. You can be a president, you can be a minister, you can be a millionaire, you can be a billionaire. In front of you, Allah, you are a beggar. Wallahu huwa al-ghaniyul hamid. Allah is ghani. Allah is the only one independent, and Allah is the only one worthy of praise. This is tabligh, my beloved brothers. This is tabligh, to take the greatness of everything else out of the heart, to take the greatness of the ghair of Allah out of the heart. Today the reliance of this insan has come upon things. Has come upon his shop, has come upon his job, has come upon degrees. Today Allah forgive us in our thinking, in the thinking of the non-reciters of La ilaha illallah. What difference is there? They have seen their success in wealth. They have seen their success in means. They have seen their success in possessions. Today we are seeing our success in the same things. We are seeing the success in the same things. Never mind what is outward, what is in the heart. What is in the heart? Allah wants this heart must be filled with Allah. Why is it a woman can never tolerate that a husband must take a second wife? Why is it? Because she cannot tolerate that there must be a partner in the affections of a husband for her. That's the main reason. Main reason. Once a woman came to the Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayh. She addressed him that, Ya Shaykh, O husband, if Allah had not ordained the veil, Allah had not ordained that a woman should cover her face, I would have removed the veil from in front of my face and shown you what beauty Allah has given me. And despite that beauty, my husband still wants to take a second wife. When he hears this statement, he falls down unconscious. His students can't understand what has happened. They are perplexed. What was there in the statement of this woman to cause the sheikh and the teacher to fall unconscious? She came to complain about her husband. When he recovered, they asked him, what is the matter? He said, Ye aurat makhlooq hokar, apne muhabbat mein sharakat bardasht nahi kar sakti. Allah khaliq hokar kaise bardasht karega? He said that this woman, despite being a creation of Allah, despite being a creation of Allah, cannot tolerate that there should be a partner with her in the affections of her husband. Allah, the creator, how is he going to tolerate? How is he going to tolerate? When the heart which Allah gave this insan, and the eyes which Allah gave this insan, and the ears which Allah gave this insan, and the hands which Allah gave this insan, and the feet which Allah gave this insan, and the strength which Allah gave this insan, is going to be used to please others besides Allah. How is Allah going to tolerate? And yet such is His love, such is His mercy, the other creations of Allah cannot tolerate. They cannot tolerate. Today we have seen a person does some crime that is zulm, oppression. He harms someone that is zulm and oppression. What greater zulm, what greater oppression is there than when the slave of Allah turns away from Allah? What greater zulm can there be than this? When the heart which Allah made, this heart, ulama explained, has to become the arsh of Allah. Ajeeb. Hadith Qudsi. Allah says, my greatness and my majesty and my glory is such that the seven heavens and the seven earths cannot contain me. But I have created the capacity in the heart of a mu'min slave, fi qalbi al-mu'min, that this heart can contain me. This heart is for Allah. It has to be filled with Allah. The ghair of Allah has to come out. من اعتمد على ماله فقد قل. من اعتمد على سلطانه فقد ذل. من اعتمد على علمه. من اعتمد على علمه فقد ضل. من اعتمد على عقله فقد اختل. ومن اعتمد على الله فلا قل ولا ضل ولا ذل ولا اختل. Ali رضي الله عنه says, that person who will rely on his intelligence, he will go astray. That person who will rely on his strength, he will be disgraced. That person who will rely on his wealth will run short. That person who will rely on his mind will be destroyed. That person who will rely on Allah, that person whose reliance has shifted from everyone's but Allah, jisne apne taluk Allah ke saath sahi kiya, Allah uske taluk sare makhlooq ke saath sahi karenge. That person who has corrected his relationship with Allah, Allah will correct his relationship with the entire creation. He will never run short, he will never be deviated, he will never be disgraced, his intelligence will never be destroyed. Fasayakfikahumullah. Allah is sufficient, Allah is sufficient. Allah complains, Alaysa Allahu bikafin abda? Oh my slave, you have turned away from me. You have gone in some other direction. I, O Allah, am I not sufficient for you? Alaysa Allahu bikafin abada? Is your Allah not sufficient for you? That in that medium, and in that vehicle, which is the greatest test of how much this heart has gone to Allah, that even in that salah, the ulama say, sifat-e abdiyat, the quality of being the slave of Allah, the quality of belonging to Allah, the medium or the stage to show that is salah. To test how much Allah has come into this heart and how much the zayr of Allah has come out of the heart, look at the salah. Even there, Ajeeb, what is salah? Once a sahabi comes to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Majma'u al-Zawaid, this Zawaid is mentioned, هَلْ إِحْتَجَبَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ عَنْ خَلْقِهِ بِشَيْءٍ غَيْرِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ O Nabi of Allah, tell us, first heaven, second heaven, third heaven, fourth heaven, fifth heaven, sixth heaven, seventh heaven, all this, then the kursi of Allah, then the arsh of Allah, is there anything else between us and Allah? After Allah's arsh, is there anything else? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells him, نعم بينه وبين الملائكة الذين حول العرش سبعون حجابا من نور وسبعون حجابا من نار وسبعون حجابا من رفارف السندس وسبعون حجابا من رفارف الاستبرق وسبعون حجابا من در أبيض وسبعون حجابا من در أخضر وسبعون حجابا من در أحمر وسبعون حجابا من در أصفر وسبعون حجابا من ضياء استضاءها من ضوء النور والنار وسبعون حجابا من ماء وسبعون حجابا من ثلج وسبعون حجابا من غمام وسبعون حجابا من ظلمة وسبعون حجابا من عظمة الله التي لا توصف. Yes, after the arsh are 70 veils of light, 70 veils of darkness, 70 veils of fire, 70 veils of coarse silk, 70 veils of fine silk, 70 veils of white pearl, 70 veils of red pearl, 70 veils of yellow pearl, 70 veils of green pearl, 70 veils of a mixture between fire and light, 70 veils of darkness, 70 veils of cloud, 70 veils of ice, 70 veils of hail, and 70 veils of Allah's azmat, which can never be described. That is after the arsh. And yes, Muslim Sharif riwayat, Allah says, Hadith Qudsi, Allah says, قَسَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي. That Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, I have divided salah between me and my slave. When my slave will stand in front of me in salah, and he will say, Allahu Akbar. Ulama say that even the raising of the hands is an indication that, Ya Allah, everything besides you is now behind me. Even the thinking of everything is now behind me. You are the greatest. He will say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise is due to Allah. Allah, who is the Rabb. Rabb of every alam, Rabb of insan, Rabb of jinnat, Rabb of the birds, Rabb of the animals, Rabb of the malaika, Rabb of every alam, Alhamdulillah, all praise is due to you only. Muslim Sharif riwayat, Allah says, I have divided that salah between me and my slaves. Allah, Ar-Rahman, Alal Arsh Istawa, Rahman is upon his arsh, such a distance, yet every veil, every boundary, every obstacle between Allah and his slave drops. Allah is directly attentive to his slave. The angels are told, this is that insan that you said will spread fitna and fasad, will spread mischief upon my earth. The windows of Jannah are open. The hoors of Jannah are told, this is your husband. Look at what he is doing to acquire my Jannah. Allah's attention is directly upon his slave. وَإِنَّ السَّاجِدَ لَيَسْجُدُ فِي قَدَمَيِّ الرَّحْمَانِ He will make sajda on the feet of Rahman. When he will make sajda, it will be on the feet of Rahman. أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ إِلَى رَبِّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَهُوَ سَاجِدْ Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, he cannot go closer to his Allah. Then he goes, when he is in sajda, every veil has been removed. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was called physically on Mi'raj and given that gift by which every ummati was given a vessel to go directly to Allah. And yet, he will say, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. And not for one second will even the thought of Allah come into his heart. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, most merciful, still the thought of Allah is not in the heart. مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ Owner of the Day of Judgment. اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ Fear your Rabb, the tremor of Qiyamah is something terrible. يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ A day when a pregnant woman will forget her child. When a pregnant woman will abort her child, when a breastfeeding mother will forget her child, when mankind will be in a drunken stupor, everyone will be fearing, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْهُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ Mother will not want to know her child, husband will not want to know his wife, no one will want to know the other. مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ Allah, you are the owner of that day. And not for one second the thought of Allah comes in. He says, Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest, and he goes into ruku'. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Glory be to my Allah, who is the greatest. And not for one second is even the thought of Allah in his hands. Sami Allahu liman hamida. Rabbana lakal hamd. Allah has heard the one who has praised him. Oh my Allah, oh our Rabb, for you is all praise. Still the thought of Allah is nothing. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ Allah knows what is in the heart. Allah knows what is in his heart. That clothes which we wear, the clothes which we wear, we cannot tolerate that it must be dirty. The containers which we eat our food on, we cannot tolerate that that must be dirty. The homes in which we live, we cannot tolerate that that must be dirty. But that heart which was for Allah, we have filled it with filth. By looking at that which displeases Allah, listening to that which displeases Allah, going to the places that displease Allah, repeatedly, again and again, knowing that our Allah is looking at us, knowing that He has absolute qudrat and power over us. Ya man ra'ana ala al-khataya, falam yafdahna. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addresses his Allah, oh my Allah, who sees us disobeying Him, who sees us disobeying Him, and still He doesn't disgrace us. That heart which was for Allah, we have made it so filthy and so black that the noor of hidayat doesn't even want to penetrate it. He will say, Allahu Akbar, go into sajda, wa inna sajida la yasjudu fi qadamihi rahman. Sajid is making sajda on the feet of Rahman. He will say, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, oh glory be to my Allah, who is the greatest, who is the highest, and not for one second will the thought of Allah come into mind. What oppression is greater than this oppression? Still Allah's mercy. يبنى آدم إلى من تلتفت إلى من هو خير مني Oh my slave, to whom are you turning your attention to? To whom are you turning your attention to? To something that is better than me? Is that shop better than your Allah? Is that wife better than your Allah? Is that business better than your Allah? Is others possessions better than your Allah? Still if his attention doesn't come back, a second time, Allah doesn't need us, yet still a second time, يَبْنَ آدَمْ إِلَىٰ مَنْ تَلْتَفِتْ إِلَىٰ مَنْ هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِّنِّي Oh my slave, to whom are you turning your attention to? Are you turning your attention to something that is better than me? Still if he doesn't come back, a third time Allah calls out. Jibreel, it is said from his forehead to his toe is a distance of 14,000 years. Yet Allah says, Ya Jibreel, such awe, such fear comes in him that his body starts shrinking till he becomes like a tiny pigeon in front of Allah. And yet this arrogant insan is standing in front of Allah and his heart is elsewhere. His mind is elsewhere. He stands in salah and plans the disobedience of Allah. If he will not remember his Allah in sajda, how is he ever going to remember his Allah in the bazaar? If he will not remember his Allah in sajda, how is he ever going to remember his Allah when he's with his family? Still Allah calls out, Oh my slave, to whom are you turning your attention to? Are you turning your attention to something that is better than me? Still if he doesn't come back, then Allah says he doesn't need me. He doesn't need me. خرجت وهي سوداء مظلمة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says that salah rises up in a dark and an ugly form and addresses the person who carried out that salah ضيعت الله كما ضيعتني may Allah destroy you like you have destroyed me حتى إذا كانت حيث شاء الله until when it reaches the point which Allah wanted لفت كما يلف الثوب الخلق it is wrapped up like a dirty cloth ثم ضرب بها وجهه and then his face is struck with that dirty cloth that we do not have a need for such a salah When the salah of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is making dua, bad dua, is cursing the musallis, then what else is going to hold back the anger of Allah? Ask ourselves, my beloveds. Today the value of deen has come out. We are hurt when our businesses are affected. We are hurt when the economy is affected. We are hurt when our livelihoods are affected. But who is there to cry for the deen of Allah? Who is there to cry for Allah's deen? This is why Hazrat Ji rahmatullah alayhi may Allah fill his qabr with noor used to say, aaj musalmano ke liye rone wale bahut hai. That today to cry for the tragedies and the afflictions of the Muslims, there are many. Lekin deen Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ke liye rone wala koi nahi. But to cry that the deen of Allah is dying, the deen of Allah is dying, that deen for which my beloved Nabi took the stones of Taif, that deen for which my beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam underwent months and months of hunger, that deen is dying. Today to cry for that, there is no one. To cry, and he used to say that until and unless the ummati of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does not learn to cry for deen, then his tears for the Muslims will be to no avail. There is no greater zulm than this. Ya ayyuhal insan, ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem. O insan, what has put you into a deception about your Rabb who is kareem? Allah wants you to become His. This heart has to belong to Allah. This body has to belong to Allah. Man ahabba lillah, wa abghadha lillah, wa ata lillah, wa mana'a lillah, faqad istakmala al-iman. He who will love for Allah's sake, hate for Allah's sake, give for Allah's sake, withhold for Allah's sake, faqad istakmala al-iman. His iman is kamal. This is kamal iman. This is perfection of iman. When the living is for Allah, when the dying is for Allah, when the world belongs to Allah, when the life belongs to Allah. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبَّا لِلَّهِ. Allah speaks in the Quran, who are those with iman? What is iman? أَشَدُّ حُبَّا لِلَّهِ. Those who have ishq for Allah. More than love. More than love. When the reliance of everything has come out and only the reliance of Allah is. When the love for anything else is because of the love for one thing, that is ish. You've heard of the incident of Layla Majnu. It is said that Majnu was, actually Majnu is his nickname. Majnu means mad person. It's his nickname he got because of how madly in love of Layla he was. But in reality, his actual name was Qais. His father's name was Silma. He belonged to a tribe of very high standing amongst the Arabs. And Layla belonged to a subclass, substandard tribe. And because of this, he brought great disgrace upon his family because he was so madly in love with her. In fact, he used to say, أَمُرُّ بِالدِّيَارِ دِيَارِ لَيْلَىٰ وَأُقَبِّلُ ذَا الْجِدَارَ وَذَا الْجِدَارَ وَمَا حُبُّ الدِّيَارِ شَغَفْنَ قَلْبِي وَلَكِنْ حُبُّ مَنْ سَكَنَ الدِّيَارَ. He used to say, I passed by the city of Layla and I began kissing the walls of that city. O people, do not feel that the love of these walls has captured my heart, but the love of the one who resides within these walls. One day a dog was walking and he began kissing the footprints of that dog. So someone asked him that, hey Majnu, what are you doing? Mad person, what are you doing? He said that sometimes, not even all the time, sometimes this dog has placed its foot in the position that Layla walked. Ish! One day his father caught hold of him in the haram and begged him that make dua to Allah, that Allah rids you of the ishq of Layla. He said, Ilahi, tubtu min kullil ma'asi, walakin hubba layla la atu. Oh my Allah, I ask forgiveness for every sin, but for the ishq of layla, I don't ask forgiveness. Allahumma la taslubni hubbaha abada, wa yirham Allahu abadan qala ameena. Oh Allah, never take the love of layla away from me. And have mercy upon those who say ameen to my dua. This was ishq. That creation of Allah, who from head to toe is full of impurities. For that creation of Allah we can have ish, but for Allah we don't have ish. The malaika of Allah cannot tolerate to see the arrogance of this insan.
Allah Ibn Kathir Rahmatullah mentions the riwayat, مَا مِنْ يَوْمٍ إِلَّا وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ تَسْتَأْذِنُ رَبَّهُ. Not a single day passes, but the angels of Allah seek permission from Allah. Oh Allah, give us permission. We will send down bolts of lightning and destroy this insan. وَالْأَرْضُ تَسْتَأْذِنُ رَبَّهُ فِي أَن تَبْتَلِيَ ابْنَ آدَمَ. The earth seeks permission from Allah. Oh Allah, give us permission. We will swallow up and suck up this insan. والبحر تستأذن ربه في أن يغرق ابن آدم. And the sea seek permission from Allah. Oh Allah, give us permission, we will drown this insan. But Allah, who is Kareem, Allah who is Rahim, Allah who is Hannan, Allah who is Mannan, Allah who is Dayan, Allah who is Ghafoor, Allah who is Wahhab, Allah who is Shakur, Allah says, إن كان عبدكم فشأنكم. If it is your slaves, then you may do whatever you want to do. وَإِنْ كَانَ عَبَدِي فَمِنِّي وَإِلَيْهِ عَبَدِي. But if it is my slaves, then it is between me and them. إِنْ أَتَانِي لَيْلًا قَبِلْتُهُ وَإِنْ أَتَانِي نَهَارًا قَبِلْتُهُ. If they will come back to me at night, I will accept them. If they will come back to me in the daytime, I will accept them. مَنْ أَعْظَمُ مِنِّي جُودًا وَكَرَمًا. Who is there that is more generous than me? Who is there that is more kind than your Allah? Ishq, every other reliance has to come out of this heart. Harun Rashid, ruler of 2/3 of the world, 3 continents he was ruling at that time. He says, you a beggar are calling me a Zahid? One who contents himself with little, I rule the world. He says, your gaze has fallen upon this dunya, which is not equivalent to the wing of a mosquito, and my gaze is on the Jannat of Allah. My gaze is on the Jannat of Allah. Compared to me, you are a Zahid. Your gaze has fallen on something that is very little. You have contented yourself with very little. Malik bin Dinar rahmatullah alayhi, once he goes into the bazaar and he sees a beautiful woman, a slave girl. In those days they used to purchase, the very wealthy people used to purchase slave girls, and she's extremely beautiful. Nowadays, under a different name, they call it Miss Universe competition. Same thing, flesh is being sold. In those days, now they say they're going to have millennium competition also. In case the slave girls used to be purchased. And it is very beautiful, sometimes 100,000 dinars, 200,000 dinars for one slave girl. She would have her own servants. She would have her own servants. So Malik bin Dinar comes in the bazaar and he sees such a slave girl. He turns to her and he says, I want to purchase you. She starts laughing in arrogance. Awa mithli, you a beggar are going to purchase someone like me? Those slave girls used to have their own servants. She says to her servant, catch hold of him, I will take him to the master. To my master, and let everyone have a laugh at his expense. So they catch hold of Malik bin Dinar and they take him to the court of her master. And she says, oh master, today a very amusing thing happened. He says, what? She says, I was in the bazaar, this beggar saw me and he said that he wants to purchase me. Everyone started laughing. So then the master addressed Malik bin Dinar and told him, that, oh Malik, what are you prepared to pay for her? You are a beggar, you are a pauper, what are you going to pay? He said, I will pay what she is worth. Then he asked, what is she worth? He said, Nawatan Mamsusatan. 2 date seeds, not even dates, date seeds. Dates where the dates have been eaten off and the seeds are left. So this master got a shock of his life. He says, what are you talking about? He says, how can she be worth more than that? She is full of faults. He says, what? Explain yourself. إِن لَمْ تَتَعَطَّرْ زَفِرَتْ. If she doesn't perfume herself, her body will start smelling. إِن لَمْ تَسْتِكْ بَخِيَتْ. If she doesn't clean her teeth, her mouth will start smelling. إِن لَمْ تَدَّهِنَّ وَتَمْتَشِتْ قَمِلَتْ وَشَعِثَتْ. If she doesn't comb and oil her hair, then lice will come on her hair, which will affect you also. In amirat an qalilin harimat, she's beautiful now, few years will pass, the beauty will no longer be there. La tasduqu fi hubbiha, she's not sincere in her love for you. Today she is yours, tomorrow she's someone else's. La tuhibbuha illa li nafsiha, she doesn't love you except because you fulfill some need for hers. Ratu haydin wa bawlin wa aqdar, there's hayz day, urine day, stool day, wa hammin wa huznin wa aqdar, anger, stubbornness, rebellion. She's full of faults, she's not worth more than 2 date seeds. Wa ana indi jariya, this is not something to tell our masturat, this is for our understanding.
He says, وَأَنَا عِنْدِي جَارِيَا.
I have one by me. Do you want to buy her? Are you interested in her? He says, describe the one you have by you. He says, خُلِقَتْ مِنْ سُلَالَةِ الْمِسْكِ وَالْعَمْبَرِ وَالزَّعْفَرَانِ وَالْكَافُورِ.
She has been created from the mixture of musk, umber, saffron and camphor.
نُورُ وَجِهَا مِنْ نُورِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى.
The nur of her face is from the nur of Allah.
لَوْ بَدَى لِلشَّمْسِ لَوْ بَدَى مِعْسَمُهَا فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ لَأَشْرَقَتْ وَأَنَارَتْ.
If her forearm had to be exposed in the darkness, it would light up.
وَلَوْ بَدَى لِلشَّمْسِ لَأَسْلِمَتْ دُونَهُ وَكَشِفَتْ.
If she had to come in front of the sun would hide away itself in shame.
لَوْ مُزِجَ بِرِيقِهَا عُجَاجٌ لَطَابْ.
If her spit had to be mixed with the oceans of the world, it will become sweet.
لَوْ دُعِيَ بِكَلَامِهَا مَيِّتٌ لَأَجَابْ.
If a dead person had to hear her, he would come to life.
If a living person had to hear her, his liver would split.
If she waved a scarf in the air, the whole earth will become fragrant.
نَشَأَتْ فِي رِيَاضِ الْمِسْكِ وَالزَّعْفَرَانِ.
She was brought up in the gardens of musk and saffron and saffron.
غُزِّيَتْ بِنَا بِمَاءِ التَّسْنِيمِ.
She was given water from Tasneem's spring to drink.
قُصِّرَتْ فِي قِيَامِ النَّحِ نَعِيمٍ.
She was kept hidden in the tents of Jannat.
حُورٌ مَقْصُورَاتٌ فِي الْخِيَامِ.
حُور that are concealed in the tents of Jannat.
110, 60 miles long, made out of pearl.
لَمْ يَطْمِثْهُنَّ إِنْسٌ قَبْلَهُمْ وَلَا جَانٌ.
No insan, no jinnat has ever touched her. Forget touching her, has ever seen her.
لَا تَصْدُقُ فِي حُبِّهَا.
Her love is sincere for you only.
She won't look at anyone else.
لَا تَغْدُرُ فِي حُبِّهَا.
Her gaze will be for no one else besides you.
No haze, no urine, no stool, no anger, no stubbornness, no rebellion.
رَاضِيَة نَائِمَة خَالِدَة مُقِيمَة.
Perpetually happy, perpetually at your side, perpetually young, perpetually fresh.
Which is better, mine or yours?
Which is better, mine or yours?
He says, "Allati wasaftaha,"
the one you described.
The one you described is better.
So Malik bin Dinar tells him that, should I tell you what her price is?
What her price is?
He says, yes, tell me.
He says, less than 2 date seeds.
Less than 2 date seeds.
Allah has made his Jannat accessible to anyone.
Less than 2 date seeds.
He says, what do you mean?
He says, leave your pleasure for the pleasure of Allah.
When half the night has passed, get up and read 2 rakat salah and cry in front of your Allah.
And share your food with the poor ones.
Then she will be yours. That is her price.
When he hears this, he says, this is the girl. And he says, that, did you hear what he has to say?
She says, yes, I have heard what he had to say, oh my master.
He says, you are free. All the slaves are free. All the servants are free. All my wealth is given in charity.
He takes the curtain of his door and he makes that into his kurta.
She, seeing this, says, if you are prepared to sacrifice, I also give up everything.
Malik bin Dinar makes the nikah of these two and they become awliya of their time.
Why? The eyes open up to the deception of this dunya.
Ad-dunya daru man la dara lahu wa malu man la mala lahu wa laha yajma'u man la aqla lahu.
This dunya, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, is the home.
He will make it his object who has no home in akhirat.
It is the wealth and the aspiration of the one who has no wealth in akhirat.
وَلَهَا يَجْمَعُ مَنْ لَا أَقْلَ لَهُ.
He will make the gathering of the possessions of this world the object of his life.
مَنْ لَا أَقْلَ لَهُ, who has got no intelligence.
What is the wing of a mosquito in front of the Jannat of Allah?
What intelligence is it to give up that for this?
What intelligence is it?
That is what Allah says. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ.
This is nothing but a deception.
You were not sent for dunya. You were not sent to fulfill your desires.
The life of this world is too short. Too short.
كَمْ لَبِثْتُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ عَدَدَ سِنِينَ.
On that day they will be asked, oh insan, how long did you live in this world?
كَمْ لَبِثْتُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ عَدَدَ سِنِينَ. How many years?
That day, when they have seen the akhirat of Allah,
khamsina alfa sana,
the first day of which is 50,000 years.
That day they will say, labithna yawman, oh Allah, we live for one day.
It may have been 100 years.
It may have been 150 years.
It may have been 200 years.
They will say, oh Allah, the life of this dunya was one day.
Labithna yawman,
oh ba'ba yawman, or a portion of one day.
وَسَلِ الْعَادِينَ. So much conviction they will have. They will say, ask those who are counting. It was only one day or a portion of one day. كَأَنَّهُمْ يَوْمَ يَرَوْنَهَا لَمْ يَلْبَثُوا إِلَّا عَشِيَّةً أَوْ دُحَاهَا. As if when they will see that day, they will realize that the life of this world was nothing but one morning or one evening. One morning or one evening. Those who had pleased Allah, those who had given themselves to Allah, those whose hearts had been filled with the love of Allah, وَرِضْوَانٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. The pleasure of Allah is the greatest thing. Those who had pleased the Allah, the announcement will be made, نِعْمَ مَتَّجَرْتُمْ فِي يَوْمٍ أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ نِعْمَتِي وَكَرَامَتِي وَرَحْمَتِي وَجَنَّتِي. How beautiful they earning. How much you have acquired in one day or a portion of one day. You have earned my bounties. You have earned my honor. You have earned my mercy. You have earned my Jannah. You have earned my Jannat. مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ. No eye has ever seen, no ear has ever heard, no mind has ever imagined. إِنَّ لِكُلِّ مُؤْمِنٍ فِي الْجَنَّةِ عَشَرَةُ خَوَاتِيمٍ. Every mu'min in Jannat will be given 10 rings on his hands. 10 rings. The first one will say, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِمَا صَبَرْتُمْ. Peace be upon you. Peace be upon you. You made sabr in the dunya. Second ring, ادخلوها بسلام آمنين. Enter into my Jannat with peace and with aman. There is no more fear for you. The third ring, وَتِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. This is the Jannat. You have become the inheritors of it because of the deeds which you did in this world. Fourth ring, رَفَعْتُ عَنْكُمُ الْحُمُومَ وَالْأَحْزَانَ. Every grief, every worry has been removed from you. Fifth ring, أَلْبَسْنَاكُمُ الْحُلِيِّ وَالْحُلَلِ. You have been given jewels to wear. You have been given the fine clothing of Jannah to wear. Sixth ring, زَوَّجْنَاكُمُ الْحُورَ الْعِينَ. We have married you to the Hura'een. To the maidens of Jannah, Anas radiallahu ta'ala says, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَدْخُلُ الرَّجُلُ عَلَى الْحَوْرَىٰ. A person will enter upon his wives from the Hur. فَتَسْتَقْبِلُهُ بِالْمُعَانَقَةِ وَالْمُصَافَحَةِ. She will embrace him lovingly. And then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells them, فَبِأَيِّ بَنَانٍ تُعَاتِي. Leave the ecstasy of that embrace. Leave the ecstasy of that gaze. What has Allah placed in her fingertip? What has Allah placed in her fingertip? They say, Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam know best. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَوْ أَنَّ بَنَانًا مِّن بَنَانِهَا بَدَى لَتَمَسَ ضَوْءَ الشَّمْسِ كَمَا تَطْمُسُ الشَّمْسُ ضَوْءَ النُّجُومِ. Like when the sun rises, the intensity of the light of the sun is such that the stars are no longer visible. They haven't gone away somewhere. Can't see them anymore. The light of the sun is too strong. In the same way, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if her forefinger had to come into this dunya, the light of the sun would disappear. وَلَوْ أَنَّ طَاقَةً مِّن شَعْرِهَا بَدَى لَمَلَأَ مَا بَيْنَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ مِّن رِيحِهَا. If one strand of her hair to come into this dunya, the whole earth from east to west will be filled with its fragrance. A person will be lying with his wife from amongst the Hura'een. إِذْ أَشْرَفَ عَلَيْهِ نُورٌ مِّن فَوْقِهِ. When a blinding light will rise up from above him. فَظَنَّ أَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى أَشْرَفَ عَلَى خَلْقِهِ. He will think to himself, Allah has made tajalli, I must go into sajda in front of Allah. But when he gets up, he will realize that it is just another of the hoors of Jannah that are smiling down upon him. And he will say, Ya Abdullah, ama laka feena min raghba. Oh, the slave of Allah, don't you desire me also? Don't you desire me also? He will say, I don't know of you. Who are you? She will say, ana min al-lawati khubina lak. I am from amongst those things which are surprises for you. Surprise. I am a special surprise. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. Don't you know that Allah says for them in Jannat is that whatever they desire, وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. And there is extra which is beyond their desires. The extra. I am from the extra. فَيَتَحَوَّلُ عِنْدَهَا. He will go from this one to the next one. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, he will find such ecstasy and beauty with her that he did not experience with the first one.